knows about me, terrestrial, what is the terrestrial magnetism or Earth's magnetic field. Okay? And then Earth's magnetic elements are also, you know that one, declination, inclination, and the horizontal components of the Earth's magnetic field. Okay? Now I will go to the next one, that is the magnetization and magnetic intensity. Before we go into that one, we call it as the magnetic materials. What are the magnetic materials? When materials are placed in the external magnetic field, that material is also getting magnetized. Such materials are called the magnetic materials. Example, iron, nickel, cobalt, these are the examples for the magnetic materials. Okay? In that one, the first one, magnetizing field. The material placed in an external magnetic field. Suppose this is the one magnetic material placed in the external magnetic field. And which magnetic field this material is magnetized such that it is such external magnetic field is called as a magnetizing field. Clear? When a material placed in the external magnetic field or that is a magnetic field is applied to the external magnetic field is applied to a material, that material get magnetized. That material get magnetized. Such field is called as the magnetizing, that is the field. That is called as the what we did, even as the magnetizing field. So that is represented by that is the B naught. B naught is equal to that is mu naught N into R. Mu naught N into R. Where N is the number of turns, R is the electric current flows through that is the coil. Okay? That is the next one. That is a magnetic induction. Magnetic induction, it means you all already know this one. That is a one material is taken, that is placed in the external, that is the magnetic field. That is the magnetic field is varied at a particular degree of that is the external magnetic field. That is this is the one that is this material is gets that is completely magnetized. So how much degree of magnetization have by that material, that is called as the magnetic induction. Magnetic induction. For example, here say that is one material is there. See, this is one material. Now that is the external magnetic field is applied to this one. At which field this gets magnetized, that field is called as the magnetizing field. How much degree of magnetized this material gets magnetized? How much degree of that is magnetized by this material, that is called as the magnetic induction. So that is magnetic induction is written like that Em is equal to mu naught n Im. Magnetizing the material, in the magnetizing material, the induced current is induced current. So that is this is the number of the this is the one thing given the induced that is the current on the induced current of the material. So that is the magnetic induction. And the third one, that is the here magnetizing field, that in it is also Tesla. And the magnetic induction, that in it is also that is the Tesla. That is say the next one, magnetization. Magnetic moment, total magnetic moment per unit value, total magnetic moment or net magnetic moment per unit value, per unit value, that is called as the magnetization. That is called as the magnetization. Magnetic moment per unit value, that is called as the magnetization. So that is a magnetization, that is a unit is that is a ampere per meter. Ampere per meter, this unit ampere per that is the meter. So that is the one your unit of the magnetization. How magnetic moment I into A, say this one, magnetic moment, that formula is written here, M is equal to I into A. So here value the meters, this is the meter square, ampere meter square, and this is the meter cube. So the 1 meter is comes here, therefore this unit is ampere per meter. Ampere per meter, the unit of magnetizing. And the magnetic intensity, the next one is the one is your that is the magnetic intensity. Magnetic field at that point, that is called as the magnetic intensity. Or in other words, that is a given the number of that is the amperes, the number of amperes, that is a ampere amperes terms, number of ampere terms per unit length, per unit length, that is called as the called a given magnetic intensity. That is called as the magnetic intensity. Clear? So that is it. See, H is equal to number of ampere turns N I divided by N. N I divided by that is the N. So this SI unit is also ampere per meter. Magnetic intensity, SI unit, ampere per that is the meter. Ampere per that is the meter. Number of amperes terms, number of ampere terms per unit length, that is called as the magnetic intensity. Magnetic or magnetic intensity formula, N I divided by N, where N is the number of turns, I is the current, L is the length. Okay, L is the length. And the next one is the magnetic permeability. The magnetic, that is the permeability. The magnetic permeability ratio of the magnetic induction, the ratio of the magnetic induction to the magnetic intensity. See, this is the mu is equal to magnetic in the ratio of the magnetic induction to the magnetic intensity. So that is this is magnetic permeability. Magnetic permeability. This is constant. Okay, that is it. This one is the the next one is the relative permeability. Relative permeability. Okay, that is it. Relative permeability. The ratio of the magnetic permeability to the magnetic permeability in the vacuum. In that is the vacuum or in the air. So this is about the ratio of the permeability of a given material to the permeability of a free space or in vacuum. In that is the vacuum. This is the only relative permeability. Mu divided by mu naught. Mu divided by, that is the mu naught. Clear?